are not supporting any military action in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
We were not provoking or supporting hostilities.
Serbia's President Milosevic has repeatedly said that the conflict in Bosnia was a civil war for which he could not be blamed. But the men in charge of the murder and ethnic cleansing in Bosnia now describe his role.
Tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci. Mislim, to nas nije trebalo ubeđivati mnogo.
Predsjednik Milošević nije smatrao da je samo priznanje, međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine nešto presudno.
The Muslims of Bosnia felt threatened. As Yugoslavia collapsed, they faced domination by their neighbor Serbia.
Moram reći ovdje otvoreno. Bosna neće ostati u krnjoj Jugoslaviji. Drugim riječima, Bosna neće i ne pristaje da ostane u velikoj Srbiji i da bude njen dio.
But Izetbegović didn't speak for all Bosnians. One third of them were Serb. They wanted Bosnia to stay in Yugoslavia, where most Serbs lived. In parliament, their leader issued a black warning.
Nemojte da mislite da nećete odvesti Bosnu i Hercegovinu u pakao, a muslimanski narod možda u nestanak. Jer muslimanski narod ne može da se odbrani ako bude rat ovdje.
Evo umjesto gospodina Janović, gospodin Izetbegović.
Ja sam, osjećao sam da se približava pakao ovaj i kao da su se vrata pakla na trenutak otvorila i kao da jedan jezik onoga plamena malo prešao preko ni svih u nas u tom trenutku.
Njegov način izlaganja, njegove poruke, možda na najbolji način objašnjavaju zašto mi i možda nećemo više da ostanemo u Jugoslaviji. To večeras govorim ovdje. I još nešto. Takvu Jugoslaviju kakvu hoće gospodin Karadžić više niko neće. Neće više niko možda osim srpskog naroda.
Očekivao sam da će doći do sukoba, ali nisam očekivao genocid.
For centuries, Muslims, Serbs and Croats had lived here together. Now they had to choose a future. Half the Yugoslav republics had gone for independence, and it was time for the Bosnians to decide.
Mi smo sami sebe doveli u situaciju u kojoj više nema zajedničkog života, jer potpuna, gotovo 100% odlučnost Srba je da ostanu u Jugoslaviji. A gotovo 100% odlučnost Hrvata i Muslimana da napuste Jugoslaviju. Tu se jasno vidjelo da Bosna ne može da opstane.
President Izetbegović called a referendum on independence. Muslims and Croats were the majority. So the president won his vote.
So we are expecting very fast recognition of the republic.
He was expecting trouble, but he didn't know it would start from his own side. It happened as the guests arrived at a Serb wedding. A Muslim killed the father of the groom. That night, Serbs hit back.
Who is? Which?
Their gunmen erected armed barricades all over the Bosnian capital.
Zahtjevi srpskog stanovništva iz Sarajeva. Pod jedan. da se bezuslovno obustave sve aktivnosti od strane predsjedništva Skupštine i vlade BiH na međunarodnom priznanju suverenosti i nezavisnosti Bosne i Hercegovine.
Neither the Bosnian police nor the Green Berets, the Muslim paramilitaries under Izetbegović, were strong enough to take on the Serbs.
Pa smo se odlučili da ne primijenimo silu. U protivnom došlo je vjerojatno do uličnih borbi u dijelu grada u kojima mi nismo imali dovoljno naših snaga da uspješno izvedemo tu akciju.
The streets of the capital fell into the hands of the rival militias. The Muslims held the city center. The Serbs much of the rest, including the strategic heights, on which they placed heavy weapons. The people of Sarajevo saw war looming and begged their leaders to prevent it.
Predsjedniče Karadžiću, predsjedniče Izetbegoviću, kao ljudi koji predvodite dva naroda, vi znate koja je u ovom trenutku vaša odgovornost. Mi apelujemo u ime javnosti koja se javlja masovno telefonima i koja predlaže vaš sastanak.
The two leaders agreed to meet at the headquarters of the Yugoslav Federal Army in downtown Sarajevo.
Bila je naravno ledena atmosfera, bilo je već jasno da su događaji otišli predaleko.
To je takva svađa bila da su oni jedan drugom unose, sa rukama u lice. Znate, ja tebi, ti meni i tako dalje. Tako da sam ja morao to malo da razdvajam.
Zadržali smo se jedan sat i kao zaključili da se sukob spriječi. Te večeri je taj sukob bio izbjegnut.
Saglasili smo se da sigurnost grada i građana predamo u ruke mješovitih patrola, vojske i milicije i policije u stvari. Mješovitih patrola.
The Bosnian Serb leader Radovan Karadžić had not really backed down. He knew that his patron, the Serb president Slobodan Milosevic, and the president of neighboring Croatia had agreed to carve up Bosnia. Rumors of this Serb-Croat deal have long circulated. Now, those involved in the talks tell what happened.
Rješenje, ono što sam ja predlagao za čitavu Jugoslaviju, da se Bosna i Hercegovina organizira kao konfederacija triju naroda, da bi sva tri naroda bila zadovoljna. Drugo rješenje je da se ide na podjelu.
Tudjman now went for partition.
Puške na rame. Nadesno.
In his capital, he initiated a series of secret meetings between the Bosnian Serbs and his clients, the Bosnian Croats.
Shvatio sam da su se Srbi i Hrvati u Bosni i Hercegovini dogovorili o podjeli Bosne.
Gdje smo se dogovorili da se ne tučemo, da prestanu bitke u dolini Neretve, između Srba i Hrvata.
Problem je bio samo u tome što niko nije vodio računa o Bošnjacima, muslimanima.
Karadžić reported to Serbia's president Milosevic. Everything was now in place for them to take over a large part of Bosnia.
Predsjednik Milošević nije smatrao da međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine je nešto presudno. On je govorio kako je Kaligula proglasio svog konja za senatora. I govorio je, ipak konj nije bio senator, prema tome Izetbegović nema državu, iako mu neko to prizna, to nije država.
Milošević controlled the Yugoslav army, but he was too clever to use it openly against Bosnia. He adopted a more devious approach.
I razmatrali smo šta će se desiti u trenutku kada oni priznaju Bosnu i Hercegovini i kad nas proglase agresorima da je naša vojska tamo. Samo Milošević i ja smo o tome razmišljali. Nismo druge uključivali. I ocenili smo da mi moramo da predupredimo njih.
They transferred every Bosnian Serb in the Federal Army to units in Bosnia. This provided Karadžić with an army of 80,000 soldiers, fully trained and equipped. Milosevic could deny responsibility, but he kept his hands on the levers of power.
Mi smo naravno njima kazali da će oni dobiti svaku našu materijalnu pomoć, jer oni nisu imali svoj budžet niti ikakve mogućnosti da sami nastave, da se organizuju, da primaju plate vojni oficiri.
Milosevic also offered his Serb paramilitaries. Armed by his secret police, led by extreme nationalists from Serbia, they were the specialists in terror.
Mi nikad nismo dobili naređenje, uvijek je to bila molba. Zamoli nas Milošević, zamoli nas Admilo Bogdanović, zamoli nas neki general, recimo Domazetović, neko drugi, kaže treba toliko i toliko dobrovoljaca za to i to mjesto i mi skupimo toliko dobrovoljaca.
The first place Milosevic sent the paramilitaries was the city of Bjelina. The Serbs wanted absolute military control there. It was the strategic crossroads of northeast Bosnia. The heavily armed Serbs captured the city in 3 days. Then they rounded up the local activists in the Muslim party.
A vijest se brzo proširile, naravno, kontradiktorne, nevjerovatne skoro, ali nažalost istinite o tome da se ubija civilno stanovništvo.
The paramilitaries invited one photographer along. His presence did not stop the executions. He caught this man's last plea to be allowed to live.
Sa ogorčenjem smo saznali šta se tamo događalo. I u sebi se kleli da se to više ne smije ponoviti. Pozivam sve građane Bosne i Hercegovine, dakle, ne samo muslimane kojima pripadam, nego i Srbe i Hrvate i pripadnike drugih nacija, baš sve.
Izetbegović called on all Bosnia's police and militia to defend the state. The next morning, the citizens of Sarajevo, in their thousands, took to the streets, demanding peace. They saw the city's tradition of tolerance, more mixed marriages than anywhere else in Yugoslavia, at mortal risk. They occupied the parliament chamber.
Vlada se raspala, narod je prepušten sam sebi.
They opposed the nationalism of both Izetbegović and Karadžić. The Serb leader could watch it all. His office was across the street in the Holiday Inn Hotel. He saw the crowd challenge his right to divide the city and attempt to march on his headquarters.
Ja sam odmah uzeo telefon i javio našoj policiji da mogu očekivati da dođu velike mase mirotvoraca, takozvanih, jel? Mirotvorci. I naša policija se obezbijedila da se to ne desi.
Imaš li paket tišta?
Koliko smo mi uspjeli vidjeti, veoma su ozbiljno povrijeđeni.
Iza zavjese, iza zavjese!
6 people were killed. In the city center, long an Izetbegović stronghold, his police soon reasserted control. They arrested the Serb snipers in the Holiday Inn. Karadžić and his followers had fled the city and taken to the hills above Sarajevo. They began sporadic mortaring and sniping to show Izetbegović who was boss.
Kada su već zagrmili topovi iznad grada, kada se grad već bio počeo, kad je počelo rušenje grada, Krajišnik je ponudio da se nađemo i da se dogovorimo, kako je rekao, Sarajevo.
They chose the now abandoned parliament building for their secret talk.
Ja sam došao prvi i kad sam došao tu, onda je bio jedan mrak.
Mi smo bili prije toga na neki način kao prijatelji smo bili, jer smo radili jedno vrijeme u toj skupštini i tako dalje.
Tada sam vidio njihovo obezbeđenje koje su imali automate sa prigušivačima i tako dalje ili tako nešto slično. Ja sam rekao, znate, slabo mi je to oružje, u Srba je to mnogo bolje. Jednostavno sam se malo našalio.
On je meni rekao ovako, ne može se izbjeći podjela grada.
Mi smo uvijek razmišljali o podjeli Sarajeva, da bi Sarajevo bilo i muslimansko i srpsko i tu nikakva tajna nije.
Ja podjelu nisam prihvatio. Mi smo se pozdravili, on je meni dao za neku uspomenu jedno pero.
The Serbs hesitated before launching an assault on Sarajevo. Their first objective was to take those parts of Bosnia closest to Serbia itself, no matter who lived there.
Sa stanovišta srpskog naroda za nas je jedino prihvatljivo da smo nezavisni, da niko ne može nad nama da dominira, da brojnost drugog naroda, recimo muslimanskog, nema na nas nikakvog uticaja. Da ne može da odlučuje našu sudbinu koliko procenata muslimana ima. To je naše pravo.
In the territories where Serbs were the majority, they took control. But between Serbia and the Serb areas of Bosnia lay a region where most of the people were Muslim. In each of the principal towns there, Garajda, Foča, Srebrenica, the local Serb leader gave an order to the Muslim mayor, disarm your police and surrender. Zvornik, the crossing point for the road and rail links between Serbia and Bosnia, also received this order.
Ja bih rekao da ipak ne postoji baš neki poseban razlog da se svijet tako sklanja u tom broju, niti da izbjegava boravak u Zvorniku, jer narod mora znati da je Srpska demokratska stranka brine o svojim građanima.
But here too, the town police had been ordered to lay down their arms. Svornik's Muslim mayor was called in and told the town would be Serb. He had no choice.
I zaista mogu da tvrdim da nema šansi za nekakvo napadanje Zvornika ni sa jedne ni sa druge strane. Može se živjeti zajedno.
But the mayor knew that Federal Army tanks had already surrounded his town.
Milošević definitivno preuzima apsolutnu kontrolu i ta zvonička operacija je planirana u Beogradu. U njoj su učestvovale snage bosanskih Srba i one su bile brojnije. Međutim, specijalne jedinice i najborbenije jedinice došle su s ove strane. To su bile direktno jedinice policije, takozvane crvene beretke. To su specijalne jedinice službe državne bezbednosti Srbije. Tu su bili dobrovoljci Srpske radikalne stranke. Tu su bili Arkanovi dobrovoljci.
Šešel, the paramilitary leader, briefed Serb forces in this hotel. According to the UN War Crimes Commission, he read out the names of leading Muslims in Svornik to be killed. The Serbs launched their attack. The city's defenders were driven out of town within the day.
Da li stalno ti priča o nekim zelenim beretkama, džest? Jel tako, ljubi?
Ja, ja ište, zeleno ili crno?
Evo imam je na glavi, ko se...
Ja, ispratnica moram. Da imaju beretke, pomogli bi nam.
Pomogli.
Ovdje se jedino puca.
That day, a UN official was driving from Serbia to Bosnia. He was stopped just outside Svornik.
Me crucé con un vehículo del Comité Internacional de Cruz Roja que me dijeron no pases, no pases, tout le monde est fou, everybody's crazy.
A paramilitary commander, proud of his work, let in a news crew. Here, the regime of terror is being established as military police try to identify the Muslims.
Y era un grado de tensión absolutamente terrible y en una de las curvas, antes de ser detenidos, patinamos, el coche se deslizó sobre sangre. Sobre todo había un fuego de artillería muy importante que venía del lado serbio del Drina. Y yo vi incluso el humo que salía de las explosiones que hacen los cañones cuando salen los proyectiles en el lado serbio.
The Serb paramilitaries were mopping up as the UN representative arrived.
Naime! Hajde izizi be! Neće tiko ništa!
Dvojice li kuću u kući?
Odi ovam!
Operacija je dugo smišljana, dugo spremana, tako da nije ništa bilo u nekoj nervozi da se zove hajde hitno treba ovo, treba ono. Sve je bilo dobro organizovano i dobro izvedeno.
Entre tanto se veían camiones pasar con cuerpos de cadáveres. Vi en varias casas alrededor milicianos metiendo cuerpos de mujeres, niños, ancianos en camiones. Yo vi por lo menos 4 o 5 camiones con cadáveres.
Some 2,000 people were unaccounted for. Nobody knows how many of them were executed on the spot, or how many were sent to concentration camps where the murder continued. The rest were expelled. 49,000 Muslims lived in Svornik. None remain. 5 centuries of Islamic life and culture there were erased. This is ethnic cleansing. It became routine as the Serbs took control of 3/4 of Bosnia's territory. In time, they learned to keep the cameras out. But ethnic cleansing continued.
Ja ne mogu da kažem da toga nigde nije bilo. To je nekada više organizovano ovde u Beogradu.
There is no one who can believe what is mentioned as a organized genocide, even organized from Belgrade and even organized by me. It's really out of all consideration.
I tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci.
Considering the tragic situation in Bosnia and Herzegovina, we have no choice, and our presidency had no choice but to appeal for a military intervention in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Instead, the international community sent a peace envoy, Lord Carrington. He put a proposal to the president: partition Bosnia into ethnic provinces.
Which of course isn't what he wanted. What he wanted was a unitary state.
On je rekao, ali dobro, šta ćete raditi? Ja sam rekao da ćemo se boriti. Ovde bih naglasio tu stvar, tada je Carrington stao na trenutak i rekao, zagustavio se i pogledao me pravo u oči i pitao, kako mislite da se borite?
It was clear to me that the overwhelming military superiority at that time, at any rate, was with the Serbs. And they were obviously being helped. I mean, President Milošević may have denied it.
A on je meni rekao tada, vi, gospodine Izetbegoviću, ne znate s kim imate posla. Oni imaju Oni imaju nekoliko hiljada tenkova, oni imaju nekoliko stotina borbenih aviona, oni imaju 3 do 4 hiljade artiljerijskih sredstava, oni imaju stokove oružja koje su gomilali 40 godina, jel vi to znate? Pa kako mislite da se oduprete?
You know, in President Izetbegović's position, he was in a very difficult position, there's no doubt whatever about it.
Ja sam rekao da mi nemamo izbora. Nama preostaje jedno da se borimo ili da kapituliramo. Ako kapituliramo, bit ćemo pobijeni.
2 weeks later, the Serbs finally launched their assault on Sarajevo. A handful of UN peacekeepers had just opened an office there. On the day of the attack, one of them was expecting a package.
I sent my administrative clerk downtown. He came back about an hour later and said, I have good news and I have bad news. And I said, what's the good news? He said, I found the post office. Great, what's the bad news? It's no longer there. It's been blown up and everything in it.
Serb saboteurs had destroyed Sarajevo's central post office, knocking out most of the city's phone lines, including those of the Bosnian presidency and defense headquarters. Three miles away, the UN's General Mackenzie indulged his passion for home video, even as he asked his soldiers in the city center what exactly he was filming.
Victor Papa, I'm watching the smoke from the downtown area. Can you tell me, is it in the direction of the presidency? Over.
Victor Papa from Victor Charlie 1, yes, it's in the direction of the presidency. Over.
From three directions, the Serb forces, backed up by the tanks and air power of the Federal Army, closed in on the heart of Sarajevo. The city's defenders included local criminal gangs, professional soldiers, even Serbs willing to fight for a multi-ethnic Bosnia.
Kulminacija je dostigla vrhunac onog momenta kada su 3-4 principska ojera prešli most Vrbanja, odnosno most Skenderija i našli su se na svojih 50 metara od skupštine grada i predsjedništva.
Pucalo je na sve strane i u jednom trenutku moj telohranitelj je rekao da je on korisniji da ide da se bori dole negdje iza zgrade, nego da bude sa mnom ovdje. Na taj način čini više pomoći. Shvatio sam da prijeti opasnost da se zgrada ne osvoji.
But Sarajevo's narrow streets gave her defenders the edge. Bosnian fighters with anti-tank missiles stopped the Serb armor in its tracks. The Bosnians then turned the tables on the Serbs and encircled the Federal Army's headquarters in the city center.
Da je tu počela borba na život i smrt. Je. Nas je bilo tamo oko 200. 70, komanda, ukupno. Njih je bilo nekoliko hiljada, znate, to je blizu stojanje, znate. Od 3 metra do 50 metra, tu su oni kredili. To je rulja jedna. To su fanatici.
The two sides had fought to a standstill. The general was surrounded in his own headquarters. Then, within hours, the Serbs would get a chance to finish off Bosnia with a single clean blow to the head. The European community had summoned President Izetbegović to peace talks.
How long are you going to stay in Lisbon? Maybe a day. I think a day only, because I can't be absent from the state more than one day.
Would you agree on a sort of a confederation for both?
We don't accept any confederation in Bosnia-Herzegovina. We don't expect it.
As usual, his daughter was by his side.
Are you going to start negotiations?
Ja sam upravo tad se vraćao u Sarajevo. Krenuli smo, zaustavili smo se bili u Rimu radi uzimanja goriva i piloti su provjerili da li imamo clearance za grad, za Sarajevo.
U jednom trenutku je, kako smo se približavali Sarajevu, tu našu laganu atmosferu je prekinuo pilot koji je izašao i rekao da je aerodrom sarajevski zatvoren.
Sarajevo Airport had been seized by the Federal Army at the start of the war. It was still under the direct control of Belgrade. To pass through here, President Izetbegović needed UN protection. General Mackenzie sent an officer to meet him.
And he went out and, if I remember correctly, stayed for about an hour and a half after the scheduled arrival time. But no President Izetbegović, and no one out there knew anything about when the aircraft was going to arrive, or even if it had left.
So the UN officer left the airport, but the president didn't know it.
Prošlo je 5 minuta lijeta, vratio se ponovo taj kopilot i rekao da na sreću imamo ponovo Sarajevo i oni nam kažu da se možemo spustiti na našu odgovornost.
Nije progovarao, onda je zovnuo pilota i rekao sletite u Sarajevo. Mi kad smo sletili, ispred aviona nas je čekao jedan major jugoslovenske armije.
Ja sam pitao gdje su posmatrači, oni kažu mi ne znamo, oni nisu došli.
Pozvao me general Đurđevac da kaže da se Alijana slepo spustio na aerodrom.
The president was now a prisoner of the man his own forces had surrounded, General Kukanjac.
Znate, mene najsmešnije kad neko počne mene da ubeđuje da on više mrzi Aliju Izetbegovića, nemoj ga mrzeti, ja imam najviše razloga za to. Ali to ne mora da znači da ga likvidirate. Ja sam pozvao Đurđevca, on je mene rekao, neko ostane u pristanišnoj zgradi, lepo sa njim, tamo imati odnos, dok ja ne konstatujem predsjedništvo Jugoslavije.
Ja sam, moram reći, bio ovako iznenađen, iskreno da budem, nije mi to, nije mi bilo neprijatno i čuti, ali sam znao da to može imati implikacije i znajući da to je naš razgovor što i da se sluša, ja sam mahinalno reagovao i kazao sam pa valjda Blagoje nisu ga uhapsili nego su ga zadržali radi njegove lične bezbjednosti u kasarni našoj tamo u Lukavici. Ne, uhapsio ga je. Blagoje nije u trenutku vjerovatno shvatio šta ja želim, šta hoću time da kažem i tako dalje.
Izetbegović alone held the government in Sarajevo together. His colleagues there didn't know the army had seized him. Earlier that day, a group of children had been airlifted from Sarajevo. In this chaos, a worried mother, who happened to have one of the few working phones in the city, managed to get through to the airport.
Ko zna kako ona je došla do broja telefona direktora aerodroma. Ni ona znala ni koga je dobila. Niti on znao ko je ta žena. On je njoj rekao otprilike, jeste gospođo, ne brinite se ništa, vaše dijete je otišlo, ništa, nemate razloga da se brinete. I predsjednik Izetbegović se u tom trenutku digao, prišao direktor je rekao, izvinjam se, hoćete mi dati slušalicu. Izetbegović je uzeo telefon i rekao, najdoslovnije, dobro večer, gospođo. Alija Izetbegović, predsjednik predsjedništva Republike Bosne i Hercegovine, pored telefona. Bila je jedna mala stanka, vjerojatno ona rekla, molim, šta, ko? On je na to rekao, da, gospođo, jeste, u pravu ste, da, Alija Izetbegović, predsjednik predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine, na telefon. Vidite, hoćete biti tako dobri, molim vas. Ja sam, znate, ovdje na aerodromu, pa bi vas ja zamolio da zovnete predsjedništvo, da kažete u predsjedništvu da sam s vama razgovarao, da se nalazim ovdje. A ako ne možete da dobijete predsjedništvo, molim vas, zovnite radio televiziju, pa vijeste radio televiziju da se nalazim ovdje i da me armija ne dozvolja da dođem u grad i da traži da idem da vidim generala Kukanjca. Da, gospođo, da, generala Kukanjca. Vjerovatno je žena, jel, sve to slušala i nije mogla da vjeruje. Ona je mahinalno ponavljala to što je o njoj govorio. Rekao je on, da, puno vam hvala. Da, jeste, eto, upravo tako. Hvala, lijepo, doviđenja, gospođo. I...
As she got on the phone to Sarajevo television, the army was removing the president to a base in Serb-controlled territory. The evening news staff began phoning round to find him.
I onda moj telohranitelj je ušao i kaže, znate, nešto se događa sa predsjednikom, traži vas s televizije.
Režim javljaju da imamo na telefonskoj liniji predsjednika predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine Alića Begovića. I kakav je vaš položaj u Lukavici?
Ja sam ovdje praktički zarobljenik. Ne, evo, general Đurđevac kaže da to nije tako.
Zašto ti ne dođeš u predsjedništvo?
Zašto što mi ne daju da dođem?
O čemu se
pa
radi?
Ne može alo. To tako, samo trenutak.
Alo, to je istina. Na kom telefonu se ti nalaziš?
Ja, nama su pokidali linije, razumiješ?
Kako ste ovi sad uspjeli dobiti?
Pa evo televizije.
Preko televizije, gospodine predsjedniče.
Radio uspostavio ove linije, ovo je preko radija.
Da. Sarajevo watched, amazed. On television, Izetbegović appointed a loyal deputy to take over in case he were killed. Ejup Gunić.
Naravno, to je jedno bilo veliko breme tereta u tom trenutku.
Alijan, samo trenutak, molim vas. Naravno, javnost prati da je predsjednik predsjedništva jedne suverene i nezavisne države uhapšen od armije koja nema legitimitet na ovoj državi. Beograd zna šta je uradio. Molim vas predsjednika, dozvolite predsjedniku da dođe na svoje radno mjesto, pustite ga iz zatvoreništva.
Gospodine general, nešto moramo da učinimo. Dajte,
moram
molim vas.
Moram učiniti, evo, gospodin Izetbegović je ovdje. Ali ja molim da nam se malo vjeruje. Mi tražimo da se nama omogući da se izvučemo iz grada Sarajeva.
Imate garanciju predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine da će put koji vi odaberete biti...
Niko nema autoriteta da obuzda ove ljude koji...
Imamo mi...
Ma ima autoriteta, kako ima?
Preduvjeti da se... Budite sigurni da teritorna odbrana sluša predsjedništvo.
Dobro, to čuješ. Dadnite tako upustvo TO-u.
Da ćemo tako pustvo TO, međutim, mi ne može država...
Ja imam dovoljno jake nerve.
Mada je on hrabar čovjek, međutim, posebno problem je predstavljala činjenica da je njegova kćerka sa njim.
Mislim da je to bila jedina noć kada nisam uopće spavao. Na drugom kraju kancelarije je bio veliki neki sat vojnički. Ja se sjećam, ja sam stajao, ležao prema tom satu. Ja sam vidio kako izbija 12 sati, pola, 1, 2, 3, 4 ujutro, 5 ujutro, ja nisam spavao. Razlog je jer su mi kćerku bili odveli. Ja sam od te kćerke ostao u strašnoj brizi.
The new deputy president telephoned the federal army commander and warned him not to harm Izetbegović.
Ja mu kažem, Milutine, sve je zatvorno oko tebe. Ptica ne može izaći, ispod tebe je prokopan tunel, nemoj se igrati sa glavom.
Naredite prekid vatre ili će, bojim se, svašta biti.
Vodi računa, da se predsjedniku ništa ne dogodi, ti ćeš fino da izađeš, dogovorit ćemo se za tvoje vojnike, ti znaš da smo sarađivali. Smiri se, Milutine, jedna mala greška, ideš u zrak do Trbevića.
They agreed to a meeting at first light in UN headquarters between the Bosnian government and the army.
Pa rekao mi Ranić doslovce, gospodine generale, nemate zemlje u svetu gdje je predsjednik zemlje, zvanično izabrane zemlje, uhapšen od vojske.
Kakva je to armija koja predsjednika jedne države kidnapuje?
Ali nema ni zemlje u svijetu gdje je komandant armije i komanda armije napadnuta od tog istih snaga tog predsjednika. Prema tome, ako ćemo razgovarati, možemo o jednovremenom puštanju i komandant armije i komanda armije iziđe iz Sarajeva, da dođe u Lukavicu, i gospodina Izetbegovića. Ganić odmah skoči, ne, predsjednik, ovo ćemo raditi, ne.
I was lobbying that we do an exchange of the two individuals and that was deemed to be a good way to start.
I dogovoreno da sa Kukancem može poći mogu poći njegovi telohranitelji, dva ili tri saradnika.
To je McKenzie ga podržao i ja sam to shvatio kao normalno i onak je bio dogovor.
General McKenzie videoed the two negotiators as they phoned the army base to report what had been agreed.
Ovde na dogovoru pred Evropom i svetom dogovorili smo se.
General McKenzie rushed off to the army base to collect Izetbegović. The deputy president walked back to Bosnian headquarters, unsure if he could keep his side of the bargain.
Ganić était très inquiet. Il m'a dit je suis pas sûr, j'ai peur, il y a des éléments incontrôlés, je suis très inquiet.
General McKenzie se pojavio u tih sati gore u posredovanju da se ja oslobodim.
But before McKenzie could leave the base, the army upped their demand. They now wanted their entire headquarters staff brought out of the city center.
At that stage, I said, hold it. There's no way I can look after a convoy. I can only look after individuals. And the president said, not to worry. I will guarantee the security of the convoy.
But while he was sitting inside a UN armored vehicle, the president could guarantee nothing. His deputy was in charge.
General McKenzie nije obavijestio šta se događa. Došlo je do neke vrste haosa.
McKenzie's plan was to drive Izetbegović through the Serb-held territory and then through the Bosnian government forces to the army headquarters. There they would pick up General Kukanjac and his men. The president and the general would lead the army convoy to the front line near the Bosnian presidency. Then the captives would be received by their respective forces. The president was reunited with his daughter. They set off through the streets which had the day before seen vicious fighting.
Vidio sam uništene tenkove sa strane koje stoje, sam gledao kroz male prozore na ovom transporteru.
There were tanks burning, there were engines blown out of vehicles sitting in the middle of the road. There were bodies, many of them in fact looked like they were sunning themselves. It was a very, very nasty, nasty scene.
The president arrived at army headquarters where General Kukanjac and his men were waiting. The troops were frantically loading their lorries, confident they had been granted safe passage.
President, did you arrange for the evacuation?
No statement.
Okay, please.
Ali niko nije dao saglasnost da oružje, arhiva, svi vojnici mogu izaći. To je ostavljeno da se rešava kasnije.
With General McKenzie's white UN car in the lead, the convoy headed out. It was surrounded on all sides by Bosnian government forces eager for revenge.
Ti ljudi koji se nalaze u konvoju, oni su prethodni dan komandovali sa granatiranjem i pucanjem po Sarajevu. Oni su bili u komandi koja je rukovodila oružanom borbom. Oni su htjeli da zauzmu Sarajevo. Ta reakcija građana i boraca na prostoru Skenderije bila spontana i tada dolazi do presjecanja kolone.
I believe a red Volkswagen Golf had driven across an intersection and blocked and split the convoy into two.
In the armored vehicle, General Kukanjac hid, but President Izetbegović peered out to see his fighters ambush the trucks behind him and seize the army's equipment.
There were Bosnian army folks with their weapons pointed in the back of the trucks, and the equipment was coming out very, very quickly.
Na sve strane se pucalo. Tad sam vidio generala Divjaka.
Bravo, Divjak, bravo.
On je pokušavao da smiri tu pucnjavu, ali ja sam vidio da se očigledno tamo gine.
Hamljar, hamljar, hamljar.
Tada sam pozivao pripadnike teritorijalne odbrane da se ne otvara vatra, da je predstavnik insistirao da se ovaj problem reši bez oružanog sukobljavanja.
President Zabegovic stood up very calm, not in the least bit panicky. General Kukanjac didn't look terribly happy.
Ja sam imao oružje, pištolj, i ja sam bio spreman u toku pokreta da ubijem Aliju i sebe.
Kukanjac held his fire. The president and General Divjak radioed their headquarters and ordered the ambush lifted. They faced mutiny.
Ovo smo ispregovarali. Sutra se nastavi sati
pregovori. Zagi, sve dogovoreno.
Tako da je jedno pola sata obavljen razgovor sa predsjednikom.
Govori Divjak da se predsjednik dovede u predsjedništvo, a da se kolona pusti.
To vrijeme još uvijek nije bila ustrojena. Armija niti je mogla naše narođenosti da svako pojedinca.
The local Bosnian commanders went back along the convoy, quieting people down, calming them down, and people, poof, disappeared.
The president made it home. The Serbs, who had nearly extinguished both him and his state, now set siege to his capital. Bosnia became a member of the UN, but nobody would help her take control of her own territory.
There will be no unilateral use of United States force. As we have said before, we are not and we cannot be the world's policeman.
Milosevic sent the Bosnian Serbs a new general to run their army, Ratko Mladic. This is what he ordered for Sarajevo.
General Mladic.
Da, izvolite.
Bez panike, ko si ti prvo?
Vukašinović.
Vukašinović?
Jesam.
Pukovnik?
Jesam.
Direktnim pogodcima držite pod vatrom predsjedništvo i skupštinu. I tucite polako u intervalima dok ja ne naredim da se prekine.
Razumem.
Began phoning round to find him.
I onda moj telohranitelj je ušao i kaže, znate, nešto se događa sa predsjednikom, traži vas s televizije.
Režim javljaju da imamo na telefonskoj liniji predsjednika predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine, Alića Begovića. I kakav je vaš položaj u Lukavici?
Ja sam ovdje praktički zarobljenik. Ne, evo, general Đurđevac kaže da to nije tako.
Zašto ti ne dođeš u predsjedništvo?
Zašto što mi ne daju da dođem?
O čemu se
pa
radi?
Ne može alo. To tako, samo trenutak.
Alo, to je istina. Na kom telefonu se ti nalaziš?
Nama su pokidali linije, razumeš?
Kako, kako ste ovi sad uspjeli dobiti?
Pa evo televizije.
Preko televizije, gospodine predsjedniče.
Radio uspostavio ove linije, ovo je preko radija.
Sarajevo watched, amazed. On television, Izetbegović appointed a loyal deputy to take over in case he were killed. Ejup Gunić.
Naravno, to je jedno bilo veliko breme tereta u tom trenutku.
Alijan, samo trenutak, molim vas. Naravno, javnost prati da je predsjednik predsjedništva jedne suverene i nezavisne države uhapšen od armije koja nema legitimitet na ovoj državi. Beograd zna šta je uradio. Molim vas predsjednika, dozvolite predsjedniku da, da dođe na svoje radno mjesto, pustite ga iz zatvoreništva.
Gospodine general, nešto moramo da učinimo. Dajte,
moram,
molim vas.
Moram učiniti, evo, gospodin Izetbegović je ovdje. Ali ja molim da nam se malo vjeruje. Mi tražimo da se nama omogući da se izvučemo iz grada Sarajeva.
Imate garanciju predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine da će put koji vi odaberete biti...
Niko nema autoriteta da obuzda ove ljude koji...
Imamo mi...
Ma ima autoriteta, kako nema?
Preduvjeti da se... Budite sigurni da teritorijalna odbrana sluša predsjedništvo.
Dobro, to čuješ. Dadnite tako upustvo TO-u.
Da ćemo tako upustvo TO-u. Međutim, mi ne može država...
Ja imam dovoljno jake nerve.
Mada je on hrabar čovjek. Međutim, poseban problem je predstavljala činjenica da je njegova kćerka sa njim.
Mislim da je to bila jedina noć kada nisam uopće spavao. Na drugom kraju kancelarije je bio veliki neki sat vojnički. Ja se sjećam, ja sam stajao, ležao prema tom satu. Ja sam vidio kako izbija 12 sati, pola, 1, 2, 3, 4 ujutro, 5 ujutro, ja nisam spavao. Razlog je jer su mi kćerku bili odveli. Ja sam zbog te kćerke ostao u strašnoj brizi.
The new deputy president telephoned the Federal Army commander and warned him not to harm Izetbegović.
Ja mu kažem, Milutine, sve...
Evo, gospodin Izetbegović je ovdje, ali ja molim da nam se malo vjeruje. Mi tražimo da se nama omogući da se izvučemo iz grada Sarajeva.
Imate garanciju predsjedništva Bosne i Hercegovine da će put koji vi odaberete biti...
Niko nema autoriteta da obuzda ove ljude koji...
Imamo mi...
Ma ima autoriteta, kako nema?
I preduvjet je da se... Budite sigurni da teritorijalna odbrana sluša predsjedništvo.
Dobro, to čuješ. Dadnite tako upustvo TO-u.
Daćemo tako upustvo TO-u. Međutim, mi ne može država...
Ja imam dovoljno jake nerve.
Mada je on hrabar čovjek. Međutim, poseban problem je predstavljala činjenica da je njegova kćerka sa njim.
Mislim da je to bila jedina noć kada nisam uopće spavao. Na drugom kraju kancelarije je bio veliki neki sat vojnički. Ja se sjećam, ja sam stajao, ležao prema tom satu. Ja sam vidio kako izbija 12 sati, pola, 1, 2, 3, 4 ujutro, 5 ujutro, ja nisam spavao. Razlog je jer su mi kćerku bili odveli. Ja sam zbog te kćerke ostao u strašnoj brizi.
The new deputy president telephoned the Federal Army commander and warned him not to harm Izetbegović.
Ja mu kažem, Milutine, sve je zatvoreno oko tebe, ptica ne može izaći, ispod tebe je prokopan tunel, nemoj se igrati sa glavom.
Naredite prekid vatre ili će, bojim se, svašta biti.
Vodi računa, da se predsjedniku ništa ne dogodi, ti ćeš fino da izađeš, dogovorit ćemo se za tvoje vojnike, ti znaš da smo sarađivali. Smiri se, Milutine, jedna mala greška, ideš u zrak do Trbevića.
They agreed to a meeting at first light in UN headquarters between the Bosnian government and the army.
Pa rekao mi Ganić doslovce, gospodine generale, nemate zemlje u svetu gde je predsjednik zemlje, zvanično izabrane zemlje, uhapšen od vojske.
Kakva je to armija koja predsjednika jedne države kidnapuje?
Ali nema ni zemlje u svijetu gdje je komandant armije i komanda armije napadnuta od tog istih snaga, tog predsjednika.
Prema tome, ako ćemo razgovarati, možemo o jednovremenom puštanju i komandant armije i komanda armije iziđe iz Sarajeva, da dođe u Lukavicu, i gospodina Izetbegovića. Ganić odmah skočio, ne, predsjednik je predsjednika, ovo ćemo raditi, ne.
I was lobbying that we do an exchange of the two individuals and that was deemed to be a good way to start.
i dogovoreno da sa Kukancem može poći, mogu poći njegovi telohranitelji, dva ili tri saradnika.
To je McKenzie ga podržao i ja sam to shvatio kao normalno i onak je bio dogovor.
General McKenzie videoed the two negotiators as they phoned the army. Then, within hours, the Serbs would get a chance to finish off Bosnia with a single clean blow to the head. The European community had summoned President Izetbegović to peace talks.
How long are you going to stay in Lisbon?
Maybe a day. I think a day only, because I can't be absent from the state more than one day.
Would you agree on a sort of a confederation for Bosnia?
We don't accept any confederation in Bosnia and Herzegovina. We don't expect it.
As usual, his daughter was by his side.
Are you going to start negotiations?
Ja sam upravo tad se vraćao u Sarajevo. Krenuli smo, zaustavili smo se bili u Rimu radi uzimanja goriva i piloti su provjerili da li imamo clearance za grad, za Sarajevo.
U jednom trenutku je, kako smo se približavali Sarajevu, tu našu laganu atmosferu je prekinuo pilot koji je izašao i rekao da je aerodrom sarajevski zatvoren.
Sarajevo Airport had been seized by the Federal Army at the start of the war. It was still under the direct control of Belgrade. To pass through here, President Izetbegović needed UN protection. General McKenzie sent an officer to meet him.
And he went out and, if I remember correctly, stayed for about an hour and a half after the scheduled arrival time. But no President Izetbegović and no one out there knew anything about when the aircraft was going to arrive or even if it had left.
So the UN officer left the airport, but the president didn't know it.
Prošlo je 5 minuta lijeta, vratio se ponovo taj kopilot i rekao da na sreću imamo ponovo Sarajevo i oni nam kažu da se možemo spustiti na našu odgovornost.
Nije progovarao, onda je zovnuo pilota i rekao sletite u Sarajevo. Mi kad smo sletili, ispred aviona nas je čekao jedan major jugoslovenske armije.
Ja sam pitao gdje su posmatrači, oni kažu mi ne znamo, oni nisu došli.
Pozvao me general Đurđevac da kaže da se Alijana slepo spustio na jedan.
The president was now a prisoner of the man his own forces had surrounded, General Kukanjac.
Znate, mene najsmešnije kad neko počne mene da ubeđuje da on više mrzi Aliju Izetbegovića, nemoj ga mrzeti, ja imam najviše razloga za to, ali to ne mora da znači da ga likvidirate. Ja sam pozvao Adžića, on je mene rekao, neko ostane u pristaništnoj zgradi, lepo sa njim, tamo imati odnos.
Milosevic. Everything was now in place for them to take over a large part of Bosnia. Koliko do
tamo? Predsjednik Milošević nije smatrao da međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine je nešto presudno. On je govorio kako je Kaligula proglasio svog konja za senatora. I govorio je, ipak konj nije bio senator, prema tome Izetbegović nema državu i ako mu neko to prizna, to nije država.
Milošević controlled the Yugoslav army, but he was too clever to use it openly against Bosnia. He adopted a more devious approach.
I razmatrali smo šta će se desiti u trenutku kada oni priznaju Bosnu i Hercegovini i kad nas proglase agresorima da je naša vojska tamo. Samo Milošević i ja smo o tome razmišljali. Nismo druge uključivali. I ocenili smo da mi moramo da predupredimo njih.
They transferred every Bosnian Serb in the Federal Army to units in Bosnia. This provided Karadžić with an army of 80,000 soldiers, fully trained and equipped. Milošević could deny responsibility, but he kept his hands on the levers of power.
Mi smo naravno njima kazali da će oni dobiti svaku našu materijalnu pomoć, jer oni nisu imali svoj budžet niti ikakve mogućnosti da sami nastave, da se organizuju, da primaju plate vojni oficiri.
Milošević also offered his Serb paramilitaries. Armed by his secret police, led by extreme nationalists from Serbia, they were the specialists in terror.
Mi nikad nismo dobili naređenje, uvijek je to bila molba. Zamoli nas Milošević, zamoli nas Radmilo Bogdanović, zamoli nas neki general, recimo Domazetović, neko drugi, kaže treba toliko i toliko dobrovoljaca za to i to mjesto i mi skupimo toliko dobrovoljaca.
The first place Milošević sent the paramilitaries was the city of Bjelina. The Serbs wanted absolute military control there. It was the strategic crossroads of northeast Bosnia. The heavily armed Serbs captured the city in 3 days. Then they rounded up the local activists in the Muslim party.
A vijest se brzo proširile, naravno, kontradiktorne, nevjerovatne skoro, ali nažalost istinite o tome da se ubija civilno stanovništvo.
The paramilitaries invited one photographer along. His presence did not stop the executions. The Serbs hesitated before launching an assault on Sarajevo. Their first objective was to take those parts of Bosnia closest to Serbia itself, no matter who lived there.
Sa stanovišta srpskog naroda za nas je jedino prihvatljivo da smo nezavisni, da niko ne može nad nama da dominira, da brojnost drugog naroda, recimo muslimanskog, nema na nas nikakvog uticaja. Da ne može da odlučuje našu sudbinu koliko procenata muslimana ima. To je naše pravo.
In the territories where Serbs were the majority, they took control. But between Serbia and the Serb areas of Bosnia lay a region where most of the people were Muslim. In each of the principal towns there, Garajda, Foča, Srebrenica, the local Serb leader gave an order to the Muslim mayor, disarm your police and surrender. Zvornik, the crossing point for the road and rail links between Serbia and Bosnia, also received this order.
Ja bih rekao da ipak ne postoji baš neki poseban razlog da se svije tako stanja u tom broju, niti da izbjegava boravak u Zvorniku, jer narod mora znati da je Srpska demokratska stranka brine o svojim građanima.
But here too, the town police had been ordered to lay down their arms. Svornik's Muslim mayor was called in and told the town would be Serb. He had no choice.
I zaista mogu da tvrdim da nema šansi za nekakvo napadanje Zvornika ni sa jedne ni sa druge strane. Može se živjeti zajedno.
But the mayor knew that Federal Army tanks had already surrounded his town.
Milošević definitivno preuzima apsolutnu kontrolu i ta zvojnička operacija je planirana u Beogradu. U njoj su učestvovale snage bosanskih Srba i one su bile brojnije. Međutim, specijalne jedinice i najborbenije jedinice došle su s ove strane. To su bile direktno jedinice policije, takozvane crvene beretke, to su specijalne jedinice službe državne bezbednosti Srbije, tu su bili dobrovoljci Srpske radikalne stranke, tu su bili Arkanovi dobrovoljci.
Šešel, the paramilitary leader, briefed Serb forces in this hotel. According to the UN War Crimes Commission, he read out the names of leading Muslims in Svornik to be killed. The Serbs launched their attack. The city's defenders.
Yo vi por lo menos 4 o 5 camiones con cadáveres.
Con Some 2,000 people were unaccounted for. Nobody knows how many of them were executed on the spot, or how many were sent to concentration camps, where the murder continued. The rest were expelled. 49,000 Muslims lived in Sfornik. None remain. 5 centuries of Islamic life and culture there were erased. This is ethnic cleansing. It became routine as the Serbs took control of 3/4 of Bosnia's territory. In time, they learned to keep the cameras out, but ethnic cleansing continued.
Ja ne mogu da kažem da toga nigde nije bilo. To je nekada više organizovano ovde u Beogradu.
There is no one who can believe what is mentioned as a organized genocide, even organized from Belgrade and even organized by me. It's really out of all consideration.
I tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci.
Considering the tragic situation in Bosnia and Herzegovina, we have no choice, and our presidency had no choice, but to appeal for a military intervention in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Instead, the international community sent a peace envoy, Lord Carrington. He put a proposal to the president: partition Bosnia into ethnic provinces.
Which, of course, isn't what he wanted. What he wanted was a unitary state.
On je rekao, ali dobro, šta ćete raditi? Ja sam rekao da ćemo se boriti. Ovde bih naglasio tu stvar, tada je Carrington stao na trenutak i rekao, zagustavio se i pogledao me pravo u oči i pitao, kako mislite da se borite?
It was clear to me that the overwhelming military superiority at that time, at any rate, was with the Serbs. And they were obviously being helped. I mean, President Milosevic may have denied it.
A oni me oni...
To je nekada više organizovano ovde u Beogradu.
There is no one who can believe what is mentioned as a organized genocide, even organized from Belgrade and even organized by me. It's really out of all consideration.
I tada je svaki put direktno Milošević tražio da se upućuju dobrovoljci.
Considering the tragic situation in Bosnia and Herzegovina, we have no choice, and our presidency had no choice, but to appeal for a military intervention in Bosnia and Herzegovina.
Instead, the international community sent a peace envoy, Lord Carrington. He put a proposal to the president: partition Bosnia into ethnic provinces.
Which, of course, isn't what he wanted. What he wanted was a unitary state.
On je rekao, ali dobro, šta ćete raditi? Ja sam rekao da ćemo se boriti. Ovde bih naglasio tu stvar, tada je Carrington stao na trenutak i rekao, zagustavio se i pogledao me pravo u oči i pitao, kako mislite da se borite?
It was clear to me that the overwhelming military superiority at that time, at any rate, was with the Serbs. And they were obviously being helped. I mean, President Milosevic may have denied it.
A on je meni rekao tada, vi, gospodine Izetbegoviću, ne znate s kim imate posla. Oni imaju nekoliko hiljada tenkova, oni imaju nekoliko stotina borbenih aviona, oni imaju 3 do 4 hiljade artiljerijskih sredstava, oni imaju stokove oružja koje su gomilali 40 godina, jel vi to znate? Pa kako mislite da se oduprete?
You know, in President Izetbegović's position, he was in a very difficult position, there's no doubt whatever about it.
Ja sam rekao da mi nemamo izbora. Mi nemamo izbora, mi nama preostaje jedno da se borimo ili da kapituliramo. Ako kapituliramo, bit ćemo pobijeni.
2 weeks later, the Serbs finally launched their assault on Sarajevo. A handful of UN peacekeepers had just opened an office there. On the day of the attack, one of them was expecting a package.
I sent my administrative clerk downtown. He came back about an hour later and said, I have good news and I have bad news. And I said, what's the good news? He said, I found the post office. Great, what's the bad news? It's no longer there. It's been blown up and everything in it.
Serb saboteurs had destroyed Sarajevo's central post office, knocking out most of the city's phone line.
70, komand, to ukup. Njih je bilo nekoliko hiljada, znate, to je blizu stojanje, znate. Od 3 metra do 50 metra, tu su oni kredili. To je rulja jedna. To su fanatici.
The two sides had fought to a standstill. The general was surrounded in his own headquarters. Then, within hours, the Serbs would get a chance to finish off Bosnia with a single clean blow to the head. The European community had summoned President Izetbegović to peace talks.
How long are you going to stay in Lisbon? I think a day only, because I can't be absent from the state more than one day.
Would you agree on a sort of a confederation for Bosnia?
We don't accept any confederation in Bosnia-Herzegovina. We don't expect it.
As usual, his daughter was by his side.
Are you going to start negotiations?
Ja sam upravo tad se vraćao u Sarajevo. Zaustavili smo se bili u Rimu radi uzimanja goriva i piloti su provjerili da li imamo clearance za grad, za Sarajevo.
U jednom trenutku je, kako smo se približavali Sarajevu, tu našu laganu atmosferu je prekinuo pilot koji je izašao i rekao da je aerodrom Sarajevski zatvoren.
Sarajevo Airport had been seized by the Federal Army at the start of the war. It was still under the direct control of Belgrade. To pass through here, President Izetbegović needed UN protection. General Mackenzie sent an officer to meet him.
And he went out and, if I remember correctly, stayed for about an hour and a half after the scheduled arrival time. But no President Izetbegović and no one out there knew anything about when the aircraft was going to arrive or even if it had left.
So the UN officer left the airport, but the president didn't know it.
Prošlo je 5 minuta lijeta, vratio se ponovo taj kopilot i rekao da na sreću imamo ponovo Sarajevo i oni nam kažu da se možemo spustiti na našu odgovornost.
Nije progovarao, onda je zovnuo pilota i rekao sletite u Sarajevo. Mi kad smo sletili, ispred aviona nas je čekao jedan major jugoslovenske armije.
Ja sam pitao gdje su posmatrači, oni kažu, mi ne znamo, oni nisu došli.
Pozvao me general Đurđevac da kaže da se Alijana slepo spustio na jedan.
The president was now a prisoner of the man his own soldiers in the city center, what exactly he was filming.
Victor Papa, I'm watching the smoke from the downtown area. Can you tell me, is it in the direction of the presidency, over?
Victor Papa from Victor Charlie 1, yes, it's in the direction front of the presidency. Over.
From three directions, the Serb forces, backed up by the tanks and air power of the Federal Army, closed in on the heart of Sarajevo. The city's defenders included local criminal gangs, professional soldiers, even Serbs willing to fight for a multi-ethnic Bosnia.
Kulminacija je dostigla vrhunac onog momenta kada su 3-4 Prinzgauera prešli most Vrbanja, odnosno most Skenderija i našli su se na svojih 50 metara od skupštine grada i predsjedništva.
Pucalo je na sve strane i u jednom trenutku moj telohranitelj je rekao da je on korisniji da ide da se bori dole negdje iza zgrade nego da bude sa mnom ovdje na taj način čini više pomoći. Shvatio sam da prijeti opasno da se zgrada ne osvoji.
But Sarajevo's narrow streets gave her defenders the edge. Bosnian fighters with anti-tank missiles stopped the Serb armor in its tracks. The Bosnians then turned the tables on the Serbs and encircled the Federal Army's headquarters in the city center.
Da je tu počela borba na život i smrt. Je. Nas je bilo tamo oko 200. 70, tako. Komand, da ukupno. Njih je bilo nekoliko hiljada, znate, to je blizu stojanje, znate. Od 3 metra do 50 metra, tu su oni kredili. To je rulja jedna. To su fanatici.
The two sides had fought to a standstill. The general was surrounded in his own headquarters. Then, within hours, the Serbs would get a chance to finish off Bosnia with a single clean blow to the head. The European community had summoned President Izetbegović to peace talks.
How long are you going to stay in Lisbon? I think a day only, because I can't be upset.
Ja mu kažem, Milutine, sve je zatvorno oko tebe. Ptica ne može izaći. Ispod tebe je prokopan tunel. Nemoj se igrati sa glavom.
Naredite prekid vatre ili će, bojim se, svašta biti.
Vodi računa da se predsjedniku ništa ne dogodi. Ti ćeš fino da izađeš. Dogovorit ćemo se za tvoje vojnike. Ti znaš da smo sarađivali. Smiri se, Milutine. Jedna mala greška, ideš u zrak do Trebevića.
They agreed to a meeting at first light in UN headquarters between the Bosnian government and the army.
Pa rekao mi Ganić doslovce, gospodine generale, nemate zemlje u svetu gde je predsjednik zemlje, zvanično izabrane zemlje, uhapšen od vojske.
Kakva je to armija koja predsjednika jedne države kidnapuje?
Ali nema ni zemlje u svijetu gdje je komandant armije i komanda armije napadnuta od tog istih snaga tog predsjednika. Prema tome, ako ćemo razgovarati, možemo o jednovremenom puštanju i komandant armije i komanda armije iziđe iz Sarajeva, da dođe u Lukavicu, i gospodina Izetbegovića. Ganić odmah skoče, ne, predsjednik je predsjednika, ovo ćemo raditi, ne.
I was lobbying that we do an exchange of the two individuals and that was deemed to be a good way to start.
I dogovoreno da sa Kukancem može poći mogu poći njegovi telohranitelji, 2 ili 3 saradnika.
To je McKenzie ga podržao i ja sam to shvatio kao normalno. I onak je bio dogovor.
General McKenzie videoed the two negotiators as they phoned the army base to report what had been agreed. General McKenzie rushed off to the army base to collect Izetbegović. The deputy president walked back to Bosnian headquarters, unsure if he could keep his side of the bargain.
Ganić était très inquiet. Il m'a dit je suis pas sûr, j'ai peur, il y a des éléments incontrôlés, je suis très inquiet.
General McKenzie se pojavio u tih sati gore u posredovanju da se ja oslobodim.
But before McKenzie could leave the base, the army upped their demand. They now wanted their entire headquarters staff brought as agreed to meet at the headquarters of the Yugoslav Federal Army in downtown Sarajevo.
Bila je naravno ledena atmosfera, bilo je već jasno da su događaji otišli predaleko.
To je takva svađa bila da su oni jedan drugom unose sa pesa rukama u lice. Znate, ja tebi, ti meni, tako dalje. Tako da sam ja morao to malo da razdvajam.
Zadržali smo se jedan sat i kao zaključili da se sukob spriječi. Te večeri je taj sukob bio izbjegnut.
Saglasili smo se da sigurnost grada i građana predamo u ruke mješovitih patrola, vojske i milicije i policije u stvari. Mješovitih patrola.
The Bosnian Serb leader, Radovan Karadžić, had not really backed down. He knew that his patron, the Serb president Slobodan Milosevic, and the president of neighboring Croatia had agreed to carve up Bosnia. Rumors of this Serb-Croat deal have long circulated. Now, those involved in the talks tell what happened.
Rješenje, ono što sam ja predlagao za čitavu Jugoslaviju, da se Bosna i Hercegovina organizira kao konfederacija triju naroda, da bi sva tri naroda bila zadovoljna. Drugo rješenje je da se ide na podjelu.
Tudjman now went for partition.
Puške na rame. Nadesno.
In his capital, he initiated a series of secret meetings between the Bosnian Serbs and his clients, the Bosnian Croats.
Shvatio sam da su se Srbi i Hrvati u Bosni i Hercegovini dogovorili o podjeli Bosne.
Gdje smo se dogovorili da se ne tučemo, da prestanu bitke u dolini Neretve, između Srba i Hrvata.
Problem je bio samo u tome što niko nije vodio računa o Bošnjacima, muslimanima.
Karadžić reported to Serbia's president Milosevic. Everything was now in place for them to take over a large part of Bosnia.
Predsjednik Milošević nije smatrao da međunarodno priznanje Bosne i Hercegovine je nešto presudno. On je govorio kako je Kaligula proglasio svog konja za senatora. I govorio je, ipak konj nije bio senator, prema tome Izetbegović nema državu, i ako mu neko to prizna, to nije država.
Milošević controlled the Yugoslav army, but he was too clever to use it openly against Bosnia. He adopted a more devious approach.
I razmatrali smo šta će se desiti.